Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today I want to show you how to edit PDF documents on your Chromebook or on your Windows computer without having Adobe Acrobat Reader on your computer, and how to do it for free. Now, these steps will work on any of the computers that you may have, such as a Macintosh, Windows, or even on your Chromebook, and I'm going to take you step by step to how to do it. But before we get into the lesson, I would like to remind everyone that if you're new to here, please subscribe to my channel and thumbs up if you like the content. Also, I love to read your comments. So let's get into the lesson. So the first thing you want to do is open up your web browser, go up the very top of the URL address box, and then click there and then type in smallpdf.com. Now I have a link to that down in the description. You can click there to go straight to it, and you'll load your PDF editor here. Now this is a free editor, and you are able to log on or log in if you need to, but we're not going to do that, nor are we going to be using this install small PDF Chrome extension. So don't do that, don't need it. So just go ahead and click that off. And basically with the free version, you're allowed to edit 2 PDF documents and save them or email them per day. The next question that comes up is, well, is this site secure? If you look at the URL address box, you'll notice that there is a padlock there before the name. Now this basically tells you that your data is secure and safe. So the safety of your data is 100% guaranteed thanks to the advanced level of security. Both their website and the file transfers have state-of-the-art SSL encryption in place. So basically all your data is being scrambled so only you can see it. Now I'm only showcasing the free version here. I'm not going to be clicking on any of the login or any of their downloads. I'm only going to be choose file, and then I'm going to be uploading my particular PDF. One of the limitations with the free version is you can only do 2 PDF documents per day. Well, if that's a limitation, you can go for the free trial or log in that way there. But again, this is just the free one there. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to ignore their advertisements and click on choose file. So I click there. It opens up to your files app. Your PDF documents should be in your downloads folder. I'm going to choose one here. And once you click on one, you notice over here on the right hand side, it shows you a preview to make sure that you're opening up the correct PDF document, which is kind of a nice feature. And once you're satisfied that you have the right one, click on open. And then it opens up into your page there. Now there's 2 different views that you have with these tools. It's the same tools, but they draw the tools a little bit differently depending on which version opens up on your screen. So what I'm going to do is, if you want to add text, go ahead and just click on add text there, and it drops down a text box. And so I'm going to type in Smith. Now I click outside of it, and then I click in the box, and I can drag that text wherever I need it to be. I need another text. We'll just click on the T again. You can move it to where you want to beforehand. Click there and then type in your name or whatever you need to be added in there. Let's do it again. So let's add text. And this time let's do it for the birth date. So we're going to go in and I'm going to type in a birth date there. And once I have the text, I can simply drag it up to where I need it to be. And so that's your text tool. Now for these other things, you can be doing that exact same thing over and over again for each of these spaces. Now if you're working with a PDF form, you don't have to go in and add each text. You simply click in the box and begin typing, but that would be a PDF form. Well, what we're working with here is a PDF document. You need to go down and notice that it says signature. Well, you have the draw tool, so you click on the draw tool. You can choose the size. There is a way to change the color as well. And then you simply draw what you want in there. So there you go. So there's the John Smith's. And then today's date there. Let's put some date in there. All right, now, once you're done drawing, you can click on done. Okay, the next thing I want to show you is, let's say we wanted to add a shape. Go ahead and click on the shape here. And we'll just choose a little arrow. And you can choose different colors. So let's say I wanted a black arrow, and then I can drag that around and choose an option there. So that's pretty easy to do. Next is the image. So if I wanted to add an image, all you gotta do is click on Add Image, and then find your images that you want to use. So we'll go in and we'll choose this Unimog here. You can resize the images by dragging the corner squares to the center to make them smaller, and then you drag the center of the image to where you want to place it, and then you let go of the mouse clicker. All right, so you can work with images. If you don't want the image, just go ahead and click on the X. That takes it off. Same is true with any shapes. Any drawing, you can always just click on the X and that'll remove it for you. And even the text can be done that way too. Now you are able to copy and paste text into here, and you do that by highlighting it and then going Control C and then going back to this editor, doing the shortcut Control V as in Victor, and that'll copy and paste that email or other text right into the box. Now once you have everything done that you want to do, you can click on the Finish button, which is found in the lower right hand corner. So you click that button there, and then you're going to be seeing that you have a preview screen. We can go in and kind of look up and down and make sure everything is done and completed, all of your signatures are in. Once you know that it's perfect, click on the blue download button. It will then download down to your hard drive, where you'll then be able to email it to others. Next, I'm going to show you another way that your PDF editor will actually look like, and this is usually the one that I usually see. So let me open up that one now. So for this, I'm going to open up a new blank tab and type in small PDF up in the URL address box, and then in the center I'm going to click on choose file. It opens up to my hard drive, and I'm going to find my PDF documents there, and this time I'm going to choose a form. So I'm going to be using a fillable supplemental timesheet. Click on open and it uploads the document there. Now the tools you'll notice up in the corner, they're the same tools, but they have a slightly different appearance up there. And it's kind of nice because with this, with the forms, you don't actually have to use the tools. You can just simply click in the document and can begin typing. So there, you just click on the employee's name. I'm going to type in John Smith. I'm going to click on the social security number. We put a number in there, and you can click in anywhere and begin typing. So you'd have to go back and forth to the text and back to the document and do this. You just simply click where you want the text to be and begin typing, so it's much quicker this way. Now if you want to add a signature, all you have to do is go up to the tools and then click on the drawing tool. Now right away you notice at the top you have this red dot. Click it and you have different colors to choose from. I'm going to choose black. Simply hold your mouse clicker down and then type in or draw in the name that you want there. You can even write in other things there, such as the date. Then once you're done, click on the done button. Now these tools that you have here, the very next one is the highlight. I'm going to be using the freehand highlighter. So I click that one, and then anything I drag my mouse across will actually highlight in that color. At the very top, you notice that you have a orange dot. Go ahead and choose any color that you want to. Next, I'm going to be using the text tool. Now with the text tool, you can click anywhere in the document and begin adding text. It doesn't have to be in one of the squares. So for this, I think I'll go ahead and type in adult school, since I work for the adult school at Selma and also for Kings Canyon Unified School District. Notice that you can change the color there to any color, just as you did with the other text. And the next tool that we want to look at is the insert shape tool. Notice that we can do a rectangle, ellipse, line, or even an arrow. So I'm going to select on arrow, and then I can drag it to where I want it to be. And once I have that, I can change the color. I'll change the blue. I can change the thickness of the line. If I don't like it, I can click on the shape there to reshape it. And if I don't want it at all, I can click on the trash can and it goes away entirely. Next is the insert image. Click it and you're greeted with your images there on your hard drive. I'm going to choose a Unimog there. You click there where you want it to be, and then you drag the corner squares to the center to make it smaller, and then drag it to where you want it to be, and you let go. So now you've edited the PDF document. You check and make sure that everything is correct the way that you want it to be. We've gone over the tools here. Now when you're done, simply click on the blue download button. It'll download the PDF down to your hard drive, where then you'll be able to email it out. So hopefully you've learned a new skill that you can use your computer with. Hey, if you like these types of instructional videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, because I love to read your comments. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel and click on the little bell icon so you receive notifications when new videos are uploaded. And by the way, I do have the free computer class going. If you want to register for that free computer class, that link will also be down in the description. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.